data is truly important, but it's not everything, despite of what he said. We need computing, we need to understand the data, and we need to understand the inner structure of all this computation, whether it is actually valid or not, and whether it is actually carrying the meaning that we want to see or not. I think this is a very exciting thing in the future that we would like to work on it.
在看片之前，大家记得分享、赞好和订阅卓见名家，最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁你就唔会错过我哋嘅最新影片。
Hong Kong U established its own and first School of Computing and Data Science. And I have to say, this is not actually a very easy journey, as you know that. This has to bring a different corners of the university, bring together, pull them together. As you all know, data science, AI, now is a hot buzzword everywhere. And most importantly, our education itself is actually at the very beginning of the rapid transformation. My son told me that, Daddy, I think you're wasting your college tuition money sending me to college because I learned half of the courses from internet. Those courses are taught by professor from MIT or Paris and somewhere else, but one course can impact 100,000 students. Think about that, actually, a magic power that AI, computing technology, to do with education itself. So we at Hong Kong U, last 2 years, I've been already asked our deans and our VPs to think, department heads to think very hard, how we're going to change, get ready for this AI tsunami coming to the education arena. A school, new school establishment. It's not actually for just a bunch of professors. They are exploring the frontier of AI and so on. And also, we are going to address very fundamental issue of education as well, and how our students to learn and so on. We envision that there will be a core. It's like egg model, the chicken egg model. You have an egg yolk, that's your core, where the mathematics, statistics, computer science resides. And we explore very foundation of the computing and how the data transmit, understand, and so on. But at the same time, we want egg white, which is how the AI and the computing impact other arenas that are important, not only for education, but also for society.
As we navigate the digital age where data-driven knowledge is paramount, there will be an increasing need for skilled professionals in the fast-growing innovation and technology sector, or INT sector for short. I'm pleased to learn that the new school at Hong Kong U will offer a range of programs on computing, data science, and statistics, including a new program on AI and data science. These programs will play a key role in cultivating the problem solvers and innovators of tomorrow. And this is perfectly in line with the government's goal of driving the growth of INT industry and data-based digital economy, as well as enlarging INT talent pool in Hong Kong.
I think many universities, including Harvard University, has been forming School of Computing and School of Data Analysis. I remember when it was formed in Harvard, when I was still in Harvard, it was one of the very exciting time. Many of the professors from different departments joined together Harvard has an engineer branch called SEAS, S-E-A-S, and they work with the Faculty of Arts and Science parallelly. And when this was formed, many of our young faculty was truly exciting. And quite a few young faculty came to tell me, data is everything. Nothing else can be more important than data. I was awed and surprised, actually, to be frank. And in the last 10 years after they formed this center, I can witness and said that data is truly important, but it's not everything. Despite of what he said, we need computing, we need to understand the data, and we need to understand the inner structure of all this computation, whether it is actually valid or not, and whether it is actually carrying the meaning that we want to see or not. I think this is a very exciting thing in the future that we would like to work on it, and we hope Chiu-Ting College students will put in efforts with the people in CDS that we can cooperate on this endeavor to understand the true meaning of computing, the true meaning of machine learning. And we need to make sure everything that we do are reliable in the long run. This happens in the history of mathematics. In the 19th century and the 20th century, several subjects has been thought to be beautiful and well done. And this is Italian algebraic geometers. They built the subject called algebraic geometry for almost 50 years. We witness beautiful creation by these mathematicians. The Italians are genius, ingenious on developing this whole subject. But many subjects, many of their theory were developed on gut feeling, assuming things are true by looking at a generic situation. Remember, generic situation. And then it works out because their intuition are so good. And we are all clapping our hands, beautiful things come out. And then gradually, we see something false come out. And this start to give alarm to many mathematicians during the early century of last century. And then important problems were found, and a new generation of mathematicians come and decide that we need to rebuild the whole concept that was developed by the algebraic geometers. And we see a new, brand new development by people in algebra, led by Aminota, Anjouet, Sarlisky, and Grothendieck. And whole century mathematics were developed to build a foundation that the Italian geometer did not know how. And it transformed the whole subject again and again. And we see great accomplishment in the last century. So what I'm trying to say is that so far we see the great computation and great achievement by AI, but many of things we are not sure. And what I said is that the Italian geometers are actually right in most cases. But yet, there are simply cases which are not right. And just because this crack, new subjects were developed and new things were found. I think this is not different from what the physicists said in the end of 19th century. We have accomplished everything. We just need to do mathematics. We understand nature until special relativity and quantum mechanics were found. And it has transformed the whole science in 20th century. I don't say that we will transform everything, but I think a rather challenging and interesting time has come to computer science that we need to understand this new subject, brand new baby that we are facing with. And as we said, there's a brand new baby is coming out today, and we hope that you see that it grow and becomes an important subject for mankind, for our country. And I think many important concepts should be developed, and I think it should be a cooperation between mathematicians, physicists, and computer scientists, not just for industry. I think now that we see AI is a great subject to make money, many people want to get into it because you want to develop something in a few years, learning what the large language model is, learning this and that, and adapt to the Chinese version, and you hope to build a new company and make a lot of money out of it. And it is true that you make money out of it. But this is not the way I see that what we should do. As a country, we have to develop something interesting, understanding nature, and unveiling what is needed for technology and for science. And I think this is a very important part that we need to face. After all, our president of China has declared that year 2035 should be the year we lead the whole world in science and technology. If we do not develop something interesting and new, it is really not fulfilling our responsibility as leading scientists for China. And I hope Hong Kong University, Tsinghua University, and all these leading universities will do the job that we need to do. And we hope Children's College will contribute some of this important endeavor with Hong Kong University together.
It reminds me when I get to Carnegie Mellon, 1988. My advisor was Nico Haberman, was the dean of the school. 1988 was the first school of computer science. And I remember asking him, you know, he was also director of National Science Foundation. He was commuting between DC and Pittsburgh. I remember asking him, you know, why Carnegie Mellon was able to grow rapidly from regional university into a national university at that time. Now it's sort of global university, leading university. He said, computing science is the most vibrating discipline because it's closer to where the problems are. It's solving real important problems. And cross-discipline, being closer to the industry, is sort of the hallmark of Carnegie Mellon. It's really emphasizing cross-discipline. And it reminds me, and looking back after the last 30 plus years, see where things are, here's how I think about this. Computing, in many ways, relative to mathematics, it's a pretty universal modeling, reasoning, discovering tool, and it's interpretable and executable. And computing is evolving into different substrates, different forms. We're at the beginning of moving, not away, sort of moving in addition to Turing, von Neumann, and Church and all those to a different substrate, and unlocking a lot of new potentials, new frontiers. And also looking back on the history where things are heading towards. In particular, and I'm a big fan of Professor Ma's work, absolutely incredible. But look at what happened to the last 20 plus years of the industry. It's the Google of the world, Microsoft Research Lab of the world, are starting discovering more and more new frontiers. And things are changing even further. It's deep mind, it's open AI. I think there is a historical undercurrent that's driving all that. I think that's where real impact is. With President Zhang and Professor Ma all talked about the transformation of the future of university, future of talent education. I think looking back, going towards where the impact is, I think is a real opportunity for all of us. It requires a changing, in my views, it requires changing mindset. It requires changing, putting our faculties, putting our students towards where the action is. for example, the leading startups, the leading activities. And Hong Kong, in many ways, is a unique place because it's sort of in between a different geography and also in the new global dynamics. I think there's a fundamental new opportunities. It's exciting beginning. I certainly look forward to future opportunities of collaborating with the faculty and students, and very much looking forward to the future of a bigger and a bigger impact. Let me end with, I think, you know, we talked about a lot about the Nobel Prizes. I personally, I think the Nobel Prizes is just a proxy for real impact. The community historically done good work. We see computer science, we see startup founders like Demis Hassabis getting Nobel Prize. I think it's just the beginning. Computing the data, the interplay between the two in a school like we're seeing today, bigger and bigger impact are yet to come.
鍾意名家分析，记得俾 like 同埋分享，支持同订阅卓见名家，最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁就唔会错过我哋嘅新片。